of this man inside Kings Island was so disturbing enough for a Butler County family to call for help. But even officers were surprised at what they saw next. And WLWT News 5's Karen Johnson has the story you'll see only on WLWT tonight. Karen?
Much more to the story came out in court today. Prosecutors are now saying the man who was arrested last week here in Kings Island had been videotaping children all day long. His name, Rodney Grisham. News 5 broke the story last week on WLWT.com after the truck driver from Dallas was arrested.
He was first noticed in the Kings Island Park because of his unusual behavior towards young children, at one point reaching out trying to take a two-year-old child from its seven- or nine-year-old sibling.
Only WLWT talked to the children involved.
She said, "Hey, buddy." He reached his arms out to get him, and I pulled him back, and my sister put her arm out to block it.
They said Grisham took off. The family told Park Security and Mason Police, and within minutes, they had Grisham. They searched his semi, which was parked in the Kings Island parking lot. They said they found three loaded guns, which Grisham wasn't supposed to have because he's a felon, prescription drugs he didn't have a prescription for, and
he had videos, children's videos. He had toys and other things such as that. In addition to the weapons, he had an asp, he had a taser.
Prosecutors say they believe Grisham was there to abduct a child. Today they confirmed what we reported last week. Grisham had been videotaping children at Kings Island that day, the camera hidden in his sunglasses.
Just a very sad sign of state of affairs.
Tonight, park goers say this has reminded them to stress the importance of stranger danger.
My children will not go with anyone unless they know the code word.
My mom always says to keep my cell phone with me, that if I ever have an emergency, just pull it out and call her or call the cops.
Lessons like these that may have helped stop Grisham in his tracks. And today, the judge kept Grisham's bond at $200,000. He'll be back in court on Thursday for a preliminary hearing. In Mason, Karen Johnson, WLWT News 5.